In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. We have come here to celebrate the mystery of love. Two separate lives become one in love. Clay and Hayden are going to take their final marriage vows. There are just a few minutes left before they begin a new stage of their life. Let us pray. Father, hear our prayer for Claire and Hayden. With faith in you and in each other, they pledge their love today. May their lives always bear witness to the reality of that love. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Good.
In response to these beautiful words, let us now rise and sing the hymn. Be seated for the second reading. Let us now rise for the reading of the Gospel. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
From the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said, "Look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they? Can any one of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your life? And why do you worry about clothes? See how the flowers of the field grow. They do not labor or spin. Yet I tell you that not even Solomon, in all his splendor, was dressed like one of these. If that is how God clothes the grass of the field, which is here today and tomorrow is thrown into the fire, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? So, do not worry, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what shall we wear? For the pagans run after all these things, and your heavenly Father knows that you need them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please be seated. Hayden and Claire lived two completely separate lives. Then they met at the barbecue, at all places. I know where it was. Something happened on that summer day, something that changed the course of their lives. They wanted to get to know each other, but the circumstances were not favorable at all. They lived far from each other and could only see each other on screen via internet, so-called long-distance relationship. Now, do you know how long such long-distance relationships last on average? Anybody can tell? No? I can tell you, 4.5 months. That's the average. Claire and Hayden kept it for several years. Their love endured. In a dramatic climax to their story, they went on a long mountain hike on a gusty, blustery day. And Hayden proposed to Claire. And she said, yes. The two separate lives have come to an end. From now on, they're going to live one life. One stage of life is over. Another one is just about to begin. They are in the process of passage. Your Hayden and Claire are going to cross the meridian of your lives. Some years ago, you could pass by each other in the street, not paying attention. Another face was just one of many, of not much importance. How many faces are there in London? Now you would recognize each other in a crowd of thousands. The face of your partner is the most important face in the world. So what happens now? What are you doing here? You embark on the journey of your marriage. You are facing the yet uncharted waters of your future. Today you are taking maybe the most important decision of your life, to build your future together. No more dreaming about my future choices. It's now about our future choices. You're going to sail off into those uncharted waters to make the voyage of your life together. There are three steps to take before you sail off together into your shared future. The first step is gratitude. You can be grateful for meeting each other. Your relationship has blossomed beyond your hopes and dreams. You can be grateful for that. You can be grateful for the love and dedication of your parents who brought you up. You can be grateful for the help of other people along your way. You can be grateful for all the clouds in the sky, for all the birds and flowers you have seen, for all the people you have met. Encouraged by the love you have received, you can take the second step, which is hope and trust. Your marriage will be happy if you, Clay and Hayden, take each new day with childlike trust. And Jesus advised us just now in the Gospel reading, do not be anxious about tomorrow. The third and final step is the love to give away generously. Open your hearts wide and discover love that is flowing out of it. There is the vast ocean of love hidden inside us. It is love waiting to be spent. We saw Claire enter the church with a bouquet. In our Gospel reading, we heard Jesus' counsel about flowers of the field. You, Hayden and Claire, can take guidance from those flowers and Claire's bouquet from flowers, generally speaking. Take flowers for your model. They would remind you that life reaches the peak of its beauty in the process of transition and growth. Leave behind the worries of the daily life and receive with gratitude and hope your love for each other. And now, Hayden and Clay, it is time to set off on your voyage. Please stand up, approach me, and answer my question. Dear Clay and Hayden, you have come together into the house of the church so that your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal in the presence of the church minister and the church community. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you through a special sacrament. He enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you now to state your intentions. Hayden and Claire, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly?
I have.
Hayden, are you resolved to take Claire to be your wife, to love her, comfort her, honor and protect her, and forsaking all others to be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Claire, are you resolved to take Hayden to be your husband, to love him, comfort him, honor and protect him, and forsaking all others to be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
I do.
I ask now a question necessary for the civil validity of this marriage. Are you, Hayden Michael O'Connor, free, lawfully to marry Claire Lucy Marie Henry?
I am.
Are you, Claire Lucy Marie Henry, free, lawfully to marry Hayden Michael O'Connor?
I am.
Since it's your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, declare your consent before God and his church. Just a second.
Good. I, Hayden Michael O'Connor, take you, Claire Lucy Marie Henry, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part.
Uh, I, Claire, Lucy, Marie, Henry, take you, Hayden, Michael, O'Connor, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death do us part.
May the Lord in his kindness strengthen the consent you have declared before the church and graciously bring to fulfillment his blessing within you. What God joins together, let no one put asunder, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I shall now bless the rings which you will exchange. I have to say a few words about the rings. They are made of platinum. Science tells us that those metals came here from outside our solar system. The merging of two stars can produce them. Astrophysicists can prove that such an event actually took place not too far away from the young solar system, very, very long ago, this metal. So let's now ask the Lord to bless this couple with his presence for the years to come, and to bless these rings as the sign of their love and fidelity. And I really ask the congregation to say Amen. Those who say Amen too quietly, that means you don't love them. These rings are made of the stardust produced by the union of two stars. May your marital union produce love, compassion, and mercy.
Amen.
These metals are immune to corrosion. May your love stand all the trials in your life.
Amen.
These rings have neither beginning nor end and remind us of eternity and perfection. May you complete each other in this life and enter together the life of the world to come. And may the Lord bless these rings which you give to each other as the sign of your love and fidelity.
Claire, I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage. With my body, I honour you. All that I am, I give to you. And all that I have, I share with you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and in the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hayden, I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage. With my body, I honour you. All that I am, I give to you. And all that I have, I share with you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
And now, what you have come for, the kiss. We come now to the universal prayer. Those who read that, please come here. Dear brothers and sisters, let us accompany this new family with our prayers, that the mutual love of this couple may grow daily, and that God in his kindness will sustain all families dwell the book.
Hear our prayer, for the body of Christ, for the well-being of his family. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the relatives and friends, and for all who have assisted this couple. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For all families throughout the world, and for the last in peace among all people. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For all members of our families, who have passed on this world, and for all who departed. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the holy people of God, and for the peace and friendship among all friends, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our And let's conclude our prayers by saying the prayer that came out of the mouth of Jesus. That's how he taught us how to pray. And so we say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation.
Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly pray to the Lord that God may mercifully pour out the blessing of his grace on these his servants, Clare and Hayden, now married in Christ. That is called nuptial blessing, the blessing that is given only at marriages. So may you just rise for the blessing. Holy Father, maker of the whole world, you created man and woman in your own image and willed that their union be crowned with your blessing. We humbly beseech you for these your servants who are joined today in the sacrament of matrimony. May your abundant blessing, Lord, come down upon this bride, Claire, and upon Hayden, her companion for life. May the power of your Holy Spirit set their hearts aflame from on high, so that they may live out together the gift of matrimony, adorn their family with children, and enrich the church. In happiness, may they praise you, O Lord. In sorrow, may they seek you out. May they have the joy of your presence to assist them in their toil and know that you are near to comfort them in their need. Let them pray to you in the Holy Assembly and bear witness to you in the world. And after a happy old age, together with the circle of friends that surrounds them, may they come to the kingdom of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May God the Eternal Father keep you of one heart and love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home. May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone. May you be witnesses to the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God. And may Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now I invite the couple to sign the paper. The witnesses should show now.
Good.
Thank you. Thank you. Like a sun.